So let's take a look at this mousepad from ROG, or from Asus, ROG Scabbard. I guess I mispronounced that, but yeah, it is a kind of in between a fabric and a hard surface. Never really heard of this material before, but apparently it is splash resistant, has some rubberized bottom there to stop it slipping around on the table, and of course have a glowing dark ROG Scabbard logo, which of course you cannot live without. And of course some details here on the one side, and again it goes over the features there, splash proof and so on and so on. And of course you can see the specifications in terms of sizing here. So it's 2 millimeters thick and 900 length and 800 wide in terms of millimeters. So it is a fairly big mouse pad. And of course here on the other side here of the four-sided box, of course you get a little illustration here of the mouse pad itself, but you also get some real-time surface feel here, and also feel of the rubber on the back on the bottom side there, which is quite nice actually. So you can feel what kind of surface the mouse pad has, and of course how the rubber feels. But yeah, let's actually get into this box here and have a closer look. First off, you are met with a little non-deodorant or deodorant. Yeah, this is just an anti-moisture bag, but why it says deodorant, I don't really know. I've seen this quite a few times on Asus products. So let's dig a little deeper and actually take the mouse pad up out of the box here. And of course, we are met with a couple of ROG Republic of Gamers stickers, one black and one silver sticker. Of course, very nice. And a warning here on the mouse pad itself that you should not fold it with the rubber side outwards. So only fold it with the mouse pad surface on the outside. I guess that will damage the surface because it is a little strange, kind of, like I said, a mixture between a cloth mouse pad and a hard surface mouse pad with this Cordura fabric. I've not heard about this before. This mouse pad was on sale, and I've had a ROG Strix mouse pad before that I really liked, so I thought let's just try another one. And you can see here the warning again. Don't roll it with the rubber side outwards. Only roll it with the mouse pad side outwards. And again here you get a little warning again. So they definitely do not want you to roll it inside out and potentially damaging the surface there. But you get the ROG Scabbard logo up there, and it's supposed to be glow in the dark, which I have not noticed in my day-to-day life. I don't really use this mouse pad in a bright environment. But anyways, let's just check it, test it out here with a G Wireless Pro. You can see it is fairly smooth. Like I said, again, between a cloth and a hard surface, it's kind of hard to describe. But I really like gaming on this one. Actually, feels just a tad smoother than the cloth surfaces that I've tried. And let's just try another G Wireless mouse here. This is a 903, the Hero Sensor version, and also feels very smooth on this one here. Only real negative side thing I can say about this mouse pad, it doesn't never really lie completely flat on my surface at least. So the rubber doesn't really get all that great surface area to work with, so it does move around a little bit. But anyways, this is my current setup. I know it is dusty. I'm not a kind of guy that dusts my things off daily. I use my stuff, and you can see here again with the Trust mouse pad, which actually is quite nice, fairly inexpensive mouse pad. And here it is with the ROG Scabbard mouse pad. You can see the monitor is just resting on the mouse pad itself, so it does create a little downforce that hopefully the mouse pad won't move around as much as the Trust one did. And it will get better than this one in terms of getting completely flat to the surface, but it's not completely flat even after a few months of using this mouse pad. It still has some air pockets in there between the rubber and the table, so kind of weird, I think. But I think it's the material that does it. It just doesn't really lay completely flat, but I haven't really noticed it in gaming, and definitely highly recommend this mouse pad if you want something in between a cloth mouse pad and a hard surface. It is fantastic, I think. And of course, you can find affiliated links in the description below if you want to check it out. But that's pretty much it for this video. I hope to see you in a future one. Take care.